Hello, and welcome to another T-Studio demo. Today, I'm going to show you how to use alternative vanishing points to draw inclines or declines for a flat plane. This technique works for both one and two-point perspective, and the concept comes in handy when drawing, say, roads that rise or fall as they move away from you. Here's the list of supplies that I use for all my perspective drawings. To start out, I set out a horizon line and vanishing point. This drawing is going to be in one-point perspective, so the vanishing point is also going to be my center of vision. And I like to label everything just to keep organized. I'm going to draw a straight path or road towards the vanishing point for my drawing. I'm also going to include a line that will run down the center of this path. Now, you don't have to add this center line, but I just think it helps sort of display the change in elevation. Now, as you can see, I've got orthogonal lines which will represent the sides of this path or plane. And I want now to place somewhere along this path an elevation change. So I draw a line across the path. I'm going to have the path plane incline in this drawing, so I need to introduce a new vanishing point. And this point is going to be located directly above my first vanishing point. And it's labeled AVP for alternative vanishing point. Where the path begins the incline, I draw lines toward the alternate vanishing point from those corners that were represented by that line that cut across the path. Next, I want to choose a spot where I want the path to level back out and head back to that first vanishing point. So that's a transversal line, and then I just draw new orthogonals that head back to the original vanishing point. It's that simple. So now I just switch to my graphite pencil and trace down the object lines so it's easier to see. To do a pathway that drops in elevation or declines as it moves away from you in space, the process is exactly the same, only you just need to remember to place that alternate vanishing point directly below your vanishing point instead of above. I've sped up the film here so that you can see the process, but it is exactly the same. The other thing I chose to do in this second drawing was to add a vertical plane, something that would represent, say, a handrail or a wall that stretched along the side of this road. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching, and happy drawing.